Archbishop Edward A. McCarthy High School is dedicated to the formation of tomorrow's leaders through the Roman Catholic experience that provides excellence in atmosphere, academics, the arts, and athletics. Our vision is to be one of the most innovative, influential, and accomplished Roman Catholic schools in the nation.
Good morning. My name is Alexandra McNamee. Please stand for our prayer and Pledge of Allegiance. Today is September 26th. Thursday of the 25th week in Ordinary Time. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. We give thanks to you, Father God, for the life of St. Paul VI. His faithful witness as a pope during a tumultuous time for the church shows that we are called to live righteously, a universal call to holiness. May all members of this Catholic school community strive to spread the gospel, looking to the pope and his bishops as examples of fidelity and personal virtue. We ask this in the name of Christ our Lord, amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Please turn to the flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Have a great day, Mavericks. Happy Class Theme Day Thursday, everyone! Today we are on a J through I period schedule. I'm Alex McNamee.
And I'm Josiah Acevedo. Let's start things off with a recap of yesterday.
Yesterday, as you all know, was Wacky Wednesday. Students roamed the halls in whatever tackiest, wackiest, or weirdest outfits they could find.
From off-season Christmas sweaters to mismatched colors or even unmatching shoes, students managed to come up with some of the most craziest outfits. Let's take a quick look.
So good that baby something's really cool looking.
He's actually holding on to my arm here.
Can you play us something?
What's up, Mavericks? I'm Alexis Lugo, live with...
Thanos!
Okay, very cool. What'd you choose to dress up as?
Thanos.
And why'd you choose to dress up like that exactly?
Because Thanos.
Those were amazing costumes. I definitely think my favorite was the Teletubby.
There was another group of Teletubbies that also was really good.
Amazing. And I cannot wait to see what is in store for today.
But enough of recapping what the students are wearing. Let's take things back further. Do you ever wonder what the teachers look like when they're our age, getting ready for their homecoming and prom?
Well, it's hard to believe that some of them were ever that age, but now that you mention it, I do wonder what the teachers dressed like back then.
Well, let's have a little throwback Thursday to see how the teachers of McCarthy looked at their homecoming.
Kinda sinner, keep me coming. My body needs a hero, come save me. Something tells me you know how to save me. I've been feeling below, oh, I need you to come in.
Now that we're seniors, we can break free!
Yeah!
probably the best video I've ever seen, if I'm being honest. Thank you, teachers, for those photos.
Very wholesome pictures.
And now let's take things back to the present with some announcements.
Teachers, don't forget to send your best-dressed student to the courtyard at 8:10 a.m. each morning for a group photo shoot.
And with Friday right around the corner, that means the one and only homecoming football game and dance is almost upon us. Sophomores and freshmen will receive their pre-ordered homecoming t-shirts today during your last period.
And if you're headed to the game, then make sure you bring extra cash, because lots of clubs are going to be selling things, such as international clubs selling ice cream sandwiches and STEM teams selling edible cookie dough. The event needs that Maverick Pride support, so please attend the game.
Speaking of that entrepreneurial spirit, today is the day to show up after school in room 406 if you're interested in joining DECA. The club is welcoming returning, new, and interested students who might just want more information. See you right after school in room 406.
Also after school this Friday, the cross-country team will be selling Smoothie King smoothies in the breezeway right after the pep rally.
And now to fill us in on all things sports, here's Christian Rosato with your Mavs Sports Minute.
What's up, Mavs? I'm Christian Rosato, and welcome back to the Mavs Sports Minute. To start things off, just a friendly reminder that the homecoming game is tomorrow at 7 p.m., and we need every single Maverick to be out there to support our team. The Mavericks are going to face off against Northeast High, where they hope to come away with a win. This week, we change things up a bit and head over to the field, turning it over to Ian Lynch, who recently had a chance to catch up with Coach Walker.
What is up, Mavs? I'm Ian Lynch. I am currently having a sit-down interview with Coach Walker as he prepares for the homecoming game this week. So, to start off, Coach, how has the team been preparing with the distraction of it being homecoming week?
Well, so far, no distractions. They came out yesterday, Monday, probably the best Monday we've had all year. They seem focused, and ready to go and try to get a win.
Is there anything specific that you guys have seen with Northeast that you're trying to take advantage of or that you need to know you need to be careful with yourself going into this game?
Well, they're very athletic. Northeast always is. You know, they're going to have better speed than we do.
With the win and loss record not being where you guys want it, is there anything that you and the coaching staff have been trying to do to change things or just to fix it?
Well, I'm not a big believer in changing a lot to fix things. We have a young team. We just have to get better at what we do. I think that's where our success is going to be long term. We've known since spring we were going to be young and that our schedule was going to be pretty difficult. And we just, our victories right now are small victories, getting more first downs in a game, throwing the ball better, protecting our passer better, playing better on defense.
Last but not least, we mentioned earlier the win-loss record not being where we want it, but what improvements have you seen from this team that you said is very young?
Well, they go out and play hard every week, and that's been from day one. And I think as coaches, what we don't want to do is lose our team emotionally, and we don't want them to get demoralized to the point where, they give up, and this team's showed a lot of character so far. They go out every week and prepare, and they get into a ball game and they try to play the best they can, and eventually it's going to pay off for them.
Leaving the McCarthy campus and moving over to the NFL, the Dolphins have officially replaced the 2017 Cleveland Browns as one of the worst teams I have ever seen. The team lost to the Cowboys 31-6, and at this point, it looks like the Finns might as well join the YMCA. In other news, Antonio Brown has decided he's done with the NFL after being released by the Patriots last Friday amongst allegations. This decision ends the bizarre saga of Antonio Brown acting like he's on Keeping Up with the Kardashians. But let's not deny the fact that despite his questionable behavior, Antonio Brown has had an outstanding career. That's all for today's segment. I'm Christian Rosato, and I'll see you next week.
Thanks for that, Christian and Ian. Now let's take things over to the cafeteria to see what we serve today. Today, the cafeteria will be serving soup du jour, oven-roasted chicken wings, garlic parmesan potatoes, and green peas alongside their regular daily selections. Also today, SGA will be selling glow sticks for tomorrow's pep rally.
And Gerlin will be at all three lunches taking pictures for $5. So get a group of friends, split up the cost, and take some pictures, because those are memories I definitely want to keep.
And that wraps up today's show, Mavericks. I'm Alex McNamee.
And I'm Josiah Acevedo. Have a fantastic theme Thursday, everyone.